NetSupport DNA features a standard multi-layered USB device control. If we start and select the USB device component, we'll see a summary for a given date range, in this case this week, showing all activity of USB devices within specific departments. Initially for the overall group hierarchy, and as we drill down and perhaps pick a department, tech support, we can see specific devices and use. And if we drill down further, we can see the owner, the logged on user at the time it was used, and whether the device was set to be allowed for use within our enterprise. And in order to control USB devices within our environment, NetSupport DNA provides two different layers of control. Firstly, if we go to our settings tab within device control, we can define our standardized policy across the enterprise, how we wish to treat unknown, removable or portable devices when they join the network. In the case here, so for a device that we know about, we can choose to say they're allowed, blocked, read-only, or a device we don't know about, do we want to allow, block them, allow them to be read but not be able to execute applications, and so on. So we can set policies that identify devices based on whether we've pre-authorized them or they're completely unknown to the organization. We also have the ability here, as an override towards an e-safety feature, the ability to disable the use of webcams within the environment as well. So once we've set our policy, perhaps we'll say non-approved devices, we want to make them blocked or read-only, we can apply those settings and they will apply to this department or subsequent departments below them. For now, we won't bother saving those, we'll say no. We can come back to our menu and you'll see we have the ability to both add and manage a device. Now there are two ways that USB devices can be added to the NetSupport DNA infrastructure. The first is that the IT manager sat at their console can select add a device and then simply add a memory stick to their local USB port, and the DNA console will detect that and add it to their inventory. The second is that an end user from their own PC can add it and from their DNA agent send a request for the device to be added. Now once they make their request, they appear in our USB device management console that we see here, and we can sort by device types, vendors, and so on. Once an item has been identified, in this case a Kingston Technology memory stick, we can edit the device and we can provide some key information. So we can give it a manufacturer name, we can override our description, and then we can choose how this device will be authorized within our organization. On one level, we could choose to drill down and assign the use of this memory stick to be restricted to only members of, for example, the admin department. And if this were applied, it would mean only users who are members of that group within the DNA hierarchy would be able to use that memory stick on their local PC. Alternatively, we can switch from department use to specific user use, and we can now drill down to find a particular user and authorize that memory stick solely for machines where they are the current logged on user. In doing so, DNA provides two very clear and simple methods for managing data security on the network. The first by setting standard policies for how we treat unknown USB memory sticks and devices on the network, and the second for allowing us to control the use of known devices to specific individuals or departments. Simple to imply, but a very powerful endpoint security solution as standard within NetSupport DNA. Thank you for viewing this tour. Please visit www.netsupportdna.com to find out more, or if appropriate, download a free 30-day trial.